The toy poodle is the smallest version of the poodle breed, but has the same general temperament and physical characteristics as its standard and miniature counterparts. Toy poodles are an intelligent, active and social breed that require regular exercise and grooming. Before I move on with the video, I want to ask you a simple question. Do you want to train your dog for any basic commands like sit and stay? Do you want to stop any of the behavioral problems of your dog like pooping inside the house, biting, jumping, or barking? If your answer is yes, please grab the free dog training secrets guide in which I have disclosed the deepest dog training secrets that professional dog trainers don't want you to know about. These training secrets would help you have a well-behaved, super intelligent, smart and obedient dog without spending hours in training him or her. This secret training technique ebook is available for free only for a limited time. So go and grab it before it's too late. Link to the free ebook and training videos is in the description below. Toy poodle appearance. Toy poodles are poodles less than 10 inches tall at the shoulders, whereas miniature poodles can measure up to 15 inches. That puts our curly toy breed on the same scale as other toy dog favorites, pugs and shih tzus. Generally, healthy toy poodles will weigh between 4 and 6 pounds. This, again, is less than a miniature poodle, who should weigh in between 10 and 15 pounds. Coat type and coat colors. Poodles have earned their reputation for being high maintenance in one crucial area, grooming. Poodle coats don't shed, but they do keep growing throughout a dog's lifetime. Your toy poodle's coat will need brushing every day to keep on top of tangles and sweep away dirt and debris before it can accumulate. It will also need trimming every 6 to 8 weeks. The coat colors are apricot, black blue, brown and many more. In addition, they list an astonishing 18 acceptable two-tone coat combinations in their breed standard. So no matter what color poodle you picture having, with a little patience and perseverance you've got a good chance of finding them. Toy poodle temperament. Toy poodles really do bear the brunt of two unfair stereotypes. That poodles are fussy and high maintenance, and that small dogs are, well, even more fussy and high maintenance. In fact, a properly raised toy poodle should have a similar disposition to a standard poodle, and the standard poodle was bred to work happily and productively alongside humans. Toy poodles should be active, proud and very smart, and gay-spirited and good-tempered. If they've been given a good amount of exercise, they should also be happy to be a bit of a lap dog at home. Separation anxiety. Toy poodles are popular companion dogs because they reciprocate our love of company. But the flip side of this is that they don't take kindly to being left out. They are likely to become stressed and bored if they're left alone in an empty house for long periods. If you work full-time, factor in the cost of a pet sitter or regular dog walker when you're deciding whether to get a toy poodle. Training and exercising your toy poodle. Many people think small dogs don't have many requirements when it comes to training and exercise. Even smaller dogs like the toy poodle need consistent training and regular exercise. Don't let their small size fool you. Toy poodles are smart, energetic, and love to join in with days out. You'll need to provide plenty of opportunities for exercise. An hour a day is the absolute minimum. You'll also need to keep them engaged with plenty of training and fun games at home. Socialization. Like all toy dogs, toy poodles mustn't be allowed to skip socializing or obedience training just because they're small enough to scoop out of trouble. Lots of socialization as a puppy will be vital to instill them with the confidence they need around people as adults. If your toy poodle will be visiting or visited by children, arranging a fun and rewarding introduction while they're still a puppy will set them up for a happy relationship in the future. Grooming requirements. If you're planning to enter your toy poodle into dog shows, then you'll need to find a dog groomer with specific experience of looking after poodles. They'll help you identify which you're allowed to choose from according to your chosen breed registry, and then choose which would be best for your toy poodle. And if all this makes you think that a corded coat might be the way to go, bear in mind they are the highest maintenance coat of all to keep clean. But, before you despair, remind yourself that the time spent grooming your toy poodle would otherwise be spent hoovering up dog hairs and lint rolling the furniture if you'd chosen a different breed of dog that sheds. General health. Through genetic good fortune and the wisdom and prudence of toy poodle breeders, there are lots of healthy toy poodles being born. However, like any breed, there are some health problems which they tend to be vulnerable to. Toy poodles can suffer from progressive retinal atrophy, cataracts, patella luxation, von Willebrand's disease, thyroid problems, lethargy, greasy skin, dry skin or skin infections, and many more. When you're searching for your toy poodle puppy, ask breeders if any of the dogs in their puppy's family tree have been diagnosed with thyroid problems. Toy poodles are intelligent breeds that suit families who can spend a lot of time with them. They don't do well being left alone. And really benefit from time spent bonding whilst training or playing. They suit families who have the time to exercise them regularly. They don't have too many severe health problems, which means they're a relatively good choice for most families. Do you want to have a well-behaved, obedient and calm pet dog without spending hours in training him? Check out the first link in the description and download the Secret Training Technique guide absolutely free. It is available for free only for a limited period of time. Thanks for watching the video. Comment below if you liked the video. Please subscribe to the channel, Little Paws Training, if you are serious about training and grooming your dog. Also, join our Facebook group where you get all the solutions to your daily doggy problems.